So I was reminded recently by a post on the Bent Rider Online forums that not everyone thinks of recumbents and cargo bikes as going together. A lot of people think of them as two different things. Like, recumbents are always these racy, fast little bikes that can't carry much except on that one rear rack, maybe. And cargo bikes are big and boxy like this. You know, they're the Dutch Long John or Bakfiets bike or the Extra Cycle or the Surly Big Dummy with the long tail. You also get things like the classic ice cream trike. I think this is a picture from Tel Aviv. Or even a classic Delta trike. This is, in a couple videos ago, I was saying this would be a good solution for hauling that caravan, the camper that GCN was trying to tow, if you put a cargo hitch in the middle of it. But recumbents and cargo bikes can go together pretty well, actually. If you're hauling cargo, it makes a lot of sense to be on a comfortable bike. You're probably going to spend a fair bit of time hauling, you're not going to be going real fast. And also, if you're not going real fast, then you might want the stability that you get from a trike or a quadricycle. And recumbents are arguably better suited to being trikes or quadricycles than upright bikes are. So there's actually a good number of commercial recumbent cargo bikes that I'll talk about now, and in the next video we'll take a look at some home-built versions. Probably the most commercial or most commercially successful that I know of is the Velo of Armadillo. These get used for last mile transport in Europe by actual shipping companies like DHL. They're really robust. Someone toured across most of Europe and Asia on one of these with a couple of kids, I believe. Trisled in Australia also makes some interesting cargo bikes and trikes. These, this one, I believe, was a prototype for their current cargo trike design, which wound up being an upright trike because they wanted to go with something that's a little more familiar to riders, but they still offer this as a sort of semi-custom build. They have also done their ute for hauling things around their factory and their industrial park, and it's just a big flatbed with four wheels, and they stuck a recumbent on there. They also built this one, which is a little wacky, but it's a portable stage, a human movable stage intended for several musicians to sit on at an event. And then eight cyclists can ride it. They all have independent drivetrains. They're, I think, using unicycle forks and hubs there, and the steering for all eight riders is linked. Trimobile is perhaps one of my favorites. Toxi, the manufacturer of this, is, I believe, a German company, and they just have a really elegant setup here. It's front wheel drive. There's a very short chain line straight to the front wheel from the bottom bracket there. They have an enormous cargo area that's uninterrupted in the back. And if you want, you can add a second seat for a second rider who drives one of the rear wheels. And it just turns into a cargo tandem. More compact also than a lot of recumbent tandems. Further, Velomobiles are surprisingly good, maybe not cargo, but utility bikes. There's a lot of space in that shell around the rider, around the seat, on either side, behind you, and you can cram a lot of groceries in. I had a Flevo bike, well, a Flevo Alouette Plus for a while. It's one of the earlier designs, a riveted aluminum Velomobile, and it can carry a lot. I'll have to track down a photo of that being used when we moved all of the stuff belonging to Bike Farm into its new location some years ago. And it's got forks along one side and, gosh, I don't even know what, buckets of parts elsewhere. But recumbents can make great cargo bikes, and in the next video I'm looking forward to talking a little bit about some home-built solutions that are, well, I don't know, I'm not sure if anything is quite as off the wall as that tri-sled mobile stage, but there are some nice unique ones.